Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, my name is Anka and I do art and illustration related videos. So if you're into that, make sure you subscribe and check out the other videos on my channel. So it is day 7 of quarantine. If you've seen my last video, you know that my boyfriend has COVID, so I'm currently in isolation at home. And yeah, it's been a journey. So I decided to take out my camera and start filming and start doing something productive. It's not like I haven't been productive. I have actually been working on some commissions with some vintage posters, and I have been painting pretty much all day long. So you will be probably seeing that in this studio vlog. I don't have too much to show you because I did back up the Patreon reward last week, unfortunately, before any of this happened, so before I went into quarantine. And I did manage to send them out, so I'm so happy I decided to send them out earlier, because December is pretty much a hectic month for sending out packages. So Patreons will be getting their rewards hopefully very soon. I also wanted to do a small review for Arteza. They were kind enough to send me this metallic watercolor palette, which is one of the main products I have been wanting since I found out about Arteza, and I haven't opened it yet. Look, you guys, it comes with two swatch cards, one black and one white, and oh my god, I can't wait to get into these colors and start painting. So you will be probably seeing that in this video as well. And I also wanted to mention that this weekend I am opening up my shop again. I kept it closed while I was in quarantine. Well, I still am in quarantine, but I'm talking to my future self. So basically, I am opening my shop again, and I will be having a birthday sale as well. This weekend is my birthday, and I wanted to celebrate it by giving you guys 31% off. I am turning 31, so use the code BIRTHDAY31 to get 31% off your purchase. I will be sending out the orders after the 8th of December, as it is the date I can go out. So I just wanted to let you guys know, in case you were interested in any of my products, or in case you wanted to purchase some calendars. I still have some, so make sure you check it out. So yeah, that's pretty much what I wanted to say. It's been a real struggle, you guys, to not see anybody. And to stay in the house and try to be productive and try not to go mad. It's also hard not being able to hug my boyfriend or do anything like that, so it feels pretty lonely, but I'm glad I have my cat. And I guess it's a temporary situation, so I need to get through it. And I'm happy nobody is in the hospital or nobody is very ill. So I think we're lucky in that perspective. So yeah, I knew that 2020 would finish off with a bang, to say the least, but yeah, I didn't expect to have my birthday in quarantine, so that's interesting. Anyways, I just wanted to thank you guys for your support on social media. I haven't been really filling up for posting that much. I'm hoping that will change soon. I have been reorganizing my drawers and stuff like that, so, and painting, pretty much painting all day long. So I hope you enjoyed this studio vlog. I hope it's not too depressing. Thank you guys so much for your support, and just keep watching, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye. Hello again, so this is Voice of Aranka here. So I will start the review. The Arteza palette comes in this cardboard box, as most Arteza products do. There's some information on the back about the paints. They are non-toxic, they are reusable when wetted, and the set comes with 24 half pens and a water brush pen, which I do appreciate. I didn't use it in this video because I don't really like using water brush pens, but it is convenient to have those. It also comes with the swatch cards, which I really, really appreciate. There's a white one and a black one, and the colors come back individually, so that was a pain in the ass to remove, but this is how the colors look. So as you can see, the first row are more warm tones, reds and pinks, and the second row are greens and blues and stuff like that. So I started off by swatching each of the colors. I noticed that with metallic watercolors, it's much easier to add a bit of water to the paints before using them. So I did that only with the second row, and the swatching process was much easier. So my initial thought when swatching them was the colors look really nice. I wish some of them were more opaque, but I think it was just a matter of breaking through the color, if that makes sense, because when I started painting with them in my sketchbook, you will see that I didn't have any issues with making them opaque. So this set is about $30 on their website. So basically you pay $1.26 per color, which I think is a really good price considering that most metallic watercolors are very expensive from what I found. As you know, I use the Feintech pearlescent watercolors very often. It's one of my favorite art supplies that I own, and I paid around $40 for it, or $46, I can't remember exactly. So this is a much cheaper alternative, and you do get a lot more colors. And by the end of the video, you will see that the effect from the colors is pretty much the same as the Feintech one. I think they are very comparable quality wise, and I do like this set a bit more because I get a lot more color variation. I'm thinking of doing a side-by-side comparison with the two palettes, so let me know in the comment section if you would like to see that. So here are all the swatches. They look really nice, and I decided to do two sketchbook illustrations, floral patterns basically. So the first illustration, I try to use more blues and greens to see how they look together. I was really drawn to the lime green color for some reason, and I also used a bit of gouache to make the painting more cohesive, and yeah, to make it look nicer. And the second illustration, I tried to use more reds and purples and stuff like that. So I tried to use as many colors as I could from the palette, and my overall user experience was a very nice one. I didn't have any trouble using the colors. I am very happy with the saturation, with the opacity, with the flow of the paint. I really like the price point. So yeah, this watercolor palette is something that I've had on my wish list for quite a while, as I've mentioned in the beginning of the video, and I totally think it's worth the money. I know I say that about most Arteza products, but this one I was really looking forward to using and did not disappoint at all. So I would recommend it. I will leave a link in the description box where you can purchase it if you do want to. I am an Arteza affiliate, but I try to keep my reviews as honest as I can. If I don't like something, I will say it, but with this watercolor palette, I really didn't find anything that I didn't like. Most of the colors performed equally, so pretty much overall a good palette. And I really like the fact that they included some iridescent colors. So there's a iridescent pink and an iridescent green, which shift in the light, and depending on what background you add them, they look different. So yeah, I think it's a really nice touch to the palette. So these are my first impressions of this watercolor palette. I think I will be getting a lot of use out of it. It's a nice change from my Feintech pearlescent one, which I will be using also, but yeah, this is a good alternative to that, and at a much lower price point. So I will let you watch the rest of the speed painting. I hope you enjoyed this studio vlog and this review. Let me know in the comment section your thoughts on everything, and thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye!